Looking to spice up your creativity? Want to explore new horizons? Well, inside of ChatGPT, I'm going to show you how to generate prompts for MidJourney, okay? And these ideas can be for t-shirts. I personally create a lot of content around print on demand, and I sell a lot of t-shirts myself, okay? So these are ideas that are just going to help you come up with different prompts to make it easier for you and your business and scale it to that next level. So without further ado, let's get into the content.
All right, I'm over here logged into my ChatGPT account. And what we're gonna do is write a description. Okay, write a description for a hippo eating, hippo cartoon. So remember this, so eating, okay. Write a description for a hippo eating cartoon. Okay, and then we're gonna hit enter. In this cartoon, a large hippopotamus is shown sitting in a river surrounded by tall grass trees. The hippo's eyes are closed in pleasure as it chomps down on a large pile of green leafy vegetation. Its jaws move up and down rhythmically as it chews, with bits of leaves falling out of its mouth and floating down the river. Interesting. And it goes on and on. But I think this right here, first description, is really good. So I'm going to copy this, come over here into MidJourney, right? And then I'm going to go ahead and hit the little dash, imagine, and then copy and paste that. And I think it's a really good description. Let's see what it populates out to us. Oh, the word pleasure. We can't use the word pleasure. Okay, so let's take it that close. Hippo's eyes are closed as a child. Okay, let's go ahead and put that and hit enter. All right, so it's generating. Give it a little bit of time. And while we have one image generating, we're gonna do another. Write a description for a monkey eating a banana. Okay, so it's gonna write a description for a monkey eating a banana. And then remember too, it's important to get as much detail. Okay, and that's the goal, to get as much detail. And this is what we're, you know, feeding MidJourney AI to give us these really awesome, like, you know, descriptions or images. I write a description of for a monkey. Okay, I've missed the cartoon. Okay, put cartoon in there for us. Okay, in the cartoon, a mischievous monkey is shown sitting down on a branch, pulling a bright yellow banana in his hands, wide open and bright into his mouth. Okay, this is cool. I like this. So it basically took what we're writing about up here about the cartoon and then put it into here for us. So don't forget to use that word. Use certain keywords. Describe what you're talking about, what you want. So if you're going to put a design for a t-shirt, or if you're going to put a design for a sticker, if you're going to put a design for a blanket, and these are all print related to print on demand products, right? As you're watching this, because it can be very powerful stuff like this, and you're just telling it certain things to help you generate a certain image. It's that can make all the difference in you creating like a top selling design for a product. Okay, so what we're gonna do is come over to MidJourney, copy that one. I think that's pretty good, right? And keep in mind too, even with KDP, I do a lot of KDP. I can see this working with KDP as well. This is really, really cool. You can see a book being generated right here. So hit enter on that one. Let's take a look at this image, the first one, right? It's not showing the whole body, right? But it's still pretty good. Okay, and I feel like this is more of like a storybook, right? Compared to, you know, like a t-shirt design, me personally. But it can still be done. Like, you can, you know, obviously take out, you know, the image of the hippo or whatever you want to do with it, but and even some, you can even have it draw the whole body. But this is just an idea, okay, as far as, you know, coming up with a t-shirt design or anything like that. But this is an awesome way to come up with unlimited ideas, you know, for like different prompts, and just generating different prompts for MidJourney. Okay, it's just playing with it, understanding it, and, you know, coming, making it come to life. So show you another example real fast. So like, say if I'm going to, so let's say monkey eating a banana, right? T-shirt design. Okay, and so just literally just as simple as that. T-shirt design, sticker, cartoon. Okay, if you want to make it a little bit more cartoony, and that's a cool way. You know, a lot of illustrations are, you know, cartoon style images, designs to go really well on t-shirts. And you can see several different top selling products on t-shirts on Amazon Merch on Demand or Amazon.com. You'll see like a cartoon type of style design that's crushing it. So just keep that in mind. We'll put that prompt in, right? And then we'll go ahead and grab that monkey eating a banana. Take that same idea, okay? And I'm gonna show you, we're gonna test this out real fast, okay? And literally, this is going, you can work this with Redbubble. Okay, oh, Redbubble, we'll type it out. So sticker, let's take a sticker, okay? Monkey eating a banana sticker, okay? Trust that. And then we're gonna go ahead and do monkey eating a banana. And then we can do cartoon. And then remember, like, black background. So if you want to take out the image and it's even more easier for you to take out, you can do that. Okay, so keep that in mind. Or no background, black background, white background, whatever it is that you want to do. So keep that in mind and hit enter. And you can see as I'm doing this type of stuff, we reached amount allowed number. Okay, so it's working on it. So we're getting the stuff in there. So like t-shirt design, look at this monkey eating a banana. Okay, that's generating, but look at this one. This is good, right? So I feel like me just, or just you in general, just looking at this type of stuff, there's just certain ideas that you can come up with, which is crazy, right? It's so powerful that you can even do this type of stuff. This is a really cool one. I like this one, left hand corner, right hand. There's actually, they're all pretty cool, but where's the banana? Yeah, oh, there's no, I don't see him peeling the white banana. It looks like he put a lemon in there, right? Still nice though, but you know, just, well, I would have to go in here and edit a few things inside of there. So now this one right here, monkey eating a banana, and all I think I did was do sticker, right? And it's still working. Give it a second, but you're gonna see. And once this is done, I'll come back up to, why is it putting it all over the place? Okay, we have the, so let's go with the sticker. You can see like the sticker, you see what the, you like right here, you can see they just did the outline for you basically, and it's ready for a sticker. You would have to come in here, you know, take out, you know, just go around the monkey itself, but you can use that within, you know, inside of, you can do it inside of Photo P, you can do it inside of Photoshop, you can do it inside, you know, Affinity Designer, you can do it in Canva. There's a few different places that you can do it in. Okay, but you get the idea and get the concept, which is really awesome. This is a pretty cool one right here. I'm not sure if what he has in his hand, maybe a little mini banana. I'm assuming this, he looks like he has a chili right here. So a squash, looks like he has a squash right here. There's a squash right here, but that's more like a banana, right? So a little few little edits and little tweaks here that you would probably have to do. But for the most part, it's getting the whole concept down, the whole idea. Now here's a monkey eating a banana with the black, with the cartoon black background. Let that finish. Okay, monkey eating a banana t-shirt design. So you can see exactly what it did. Crazy, right? Crazy. I'm not sure what the heck's in there, right? But like, you're getting the concept, you're getting the idea, right? This is amazing. So I would probably literally just retype it in, you know, and so I'm not sure if it's getting that correctly. I don't think it's getting the idea of the banana correctly. So you would redo it, have them redo the image. You can, you know, literally just press, you know, and it'll redo the image again. This one's pretty good. And if you come down here, here's the black background. You can see what I did here. Now going back up to the t-shirt real fast, talk a little bit more about this. You can see exactly, you know, the concept and the idea and how they're, it looks more like a t-shirt design, which is really cool. That, you know, that t-shirt style design, which is cool, right? So you can see just messing around with it. You can see sticker. And then if we come over here to like cartoon, what we did right here was monkey eating a banana cartoon black background. Literally, if I just even switch it over to, you know, come over here, imagine, and then put like a cartoon, okay, and put white background, it'll turn it into a white background. That's just if you just want a white background, right? But you're seeing like just describing to the AI what you want, and then it's giving it to you, right? So even if like we suck, like this, the banana looks a little better here. The bananas look a little better here. This one here, right? That's all right there. This one, no. But right here and right here looks a little better, right? So kind of you get the concept and get the idea. This monkey looks pretty clean. This one, they all look pretty cool in their own way, right? They all have a different style, which is cool. So the idea here is coming over here into, you know, ChatGPT, and having it write a description for you based on, you know, whatever type of keyword that you're looking for, or, you know, switching out monkey eating a banana to like, you know, a hippo cartoon eating, or hippo in the water, stuff like that. Just coming up with a good description, or describing a certain animal, panda eating in the jungle, or monkey eating in the jungle, or something like that. It will generate really good descriptions for you, and you're just going to copy those descriptions and throw them over into MidJourney. Okay, so, and it will generate images like this for us. Okay, you can see what we did right here. It's doing the white background monkey with the white background, which is really cool. So you get the concept, you get the idea. Make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up and watch this next video right here if you want to learn more about different prompt generators with MidJourney.